Today we are starting with CFSE, that is crystal field stabilization energy. And this crystal field stabilization energy requires lot of informations, and that informations are basically reported to be on the basis of strong ligand and weak ligand. Strong ligand and weak ligand. Strong ligands and weak ligands, if you take, remember one thing, I have already explained to you, strong ligands are those ligands in which pairing up of unpaired electrons takes place. Weak ligands are those ligands in which pairing up of unpaired electrons do not take place. That is why it is called P. P is called pairing energy required to pair up unpaired electron. Okay. Now see, if I just want to see a CFSE value, how to find out a CFSE value? We will be doing it with octahedral high spin and low spin complexes, that is strong ligand and weak ligand. We'll talk about it. First thing, if you talk about octahedral spin, that is Eg at the top and P2G is at the bottom. Okay? When the electron goes into the T2G level, when it goes into the T2G level, then the electron, if it goes and submits itself in T2G level, that will have a contribution of energy of 0.4 dq. What is dq? Dq means Debye quotient. And if the electron goes and submits itself in Eg level, so T2G level, Eg level, delta O, okay, then it's called plus 0.6 dq. This is minus 0.6 dq and this is plus 0.6 dq. That means if the electron goes and submits itself in T2G level, that will become what? That will contribute an energy of minus 0.4 dq. And this is what? If the electron goes and submits into the Eg level, that will contribute 0.6 dq plus. So that means this is what we are more interested in finding out a CFSE right now. Okay? So we are starting with CFSE. On the context of CFSE, we are starting with octahedral. Okay, I am doing today only octahedral low spin complex, that is strong ligand. Octahedral low spin complex, that is strong ligand. We draw up all the lines over here. We see this is what? Dn. This is T2G. This is Eg, this is number of unpaired electron, and this is spin, and this is CFSE value. Okay, so we have all these data to be done right now. Slowly we do it. Only octahedral low spin, that is strong ligands, only for strong ligands we do it. Let us start this one. That is Eg at the top, T2G is at the bottom. Let us start. Dn, that is D1. First electrons, D1, it goes to T2G1. Octahedral, Eg at the top, T2G at the bottom, delta 1. This is T2G, this is Eg. T2G1, Eg0. Unpaired electron, 1. Unpaired electron, 1. Spin value, half. CFSE, minus 0.4 dq. Just now I have told you that when it goes and submits into the T2G level, the experimental value of what? The experimental value of T2G will be equal to minus 0.4 dq. Minus 0.4 dq will be the experimental value. So that means this is the conditions over here. Similarly, you have got D2. So this is what? T2G2, Eg0. Unpaired electron 2. 2. 1. Why 1? Half plus half is what? 1. Half plus half is 1. 1. That is 0.8 dq. Then D3. If you take D3. Okay. So if I take D3 over here. T2G3 Eg0. Eg0. That is unpaired electron 3. and that is equal to क्या 3/2, because half plus half plus half that becomes what 3/2, and this is what -1.2 dQ, correct? This is what 0.4 plus 0.4 plus 0.4, then d4, then this is coming up to be what d4, that means the electron will go and sit over here only. Why? Because it is a high spin complex, low spin complex. Low spin complex means what? Strong ligands. Strong ligands are those ligands in which pairing up of unpaired electrons will usually take place. D4. That means Eg 0. That means number of unpaired electrons 2. The value is what? 1. Spin value will become what? 1. Half and half is what? 1. And that is equal to -1.6 dQ. Char electron are here. So 1, 4 into 0.4 is equal to kya? Below 1.6 dQ. Similarly, D5 is there. T2G5, Eg 0, unpaired electron 1, half is the value spin, and this is what, -2.0 dQ, okay. Similarly, D6 is there, D6, the T2G6, Eg 0, unpaired electron becomes what, 0, half, the spin value becomes also 0, okay. Spin value becomes 0 over here, because this is what, unpaired electron is becoming 0 over here, spin value becomes 0, no unpaired electrons, each and every unpaired electron will contribute half of values over here, that is equal to -2.4 dQ, okay. Similarly, D7 is there, T2G6, Eg1, unpaired electron 1, 1 unpaired electrons are there, half value. Now, I told you that -2.4 plus 0.6 dQ, that is equal to -1.8 dQ. Why plus 0.6 dQ? You can understand this is what Eg is in the cap, plus 0.6 dQ itself. That is what, 1.8 dQ. D8, T2G6, Eg2. Eg2 is there. That is equal to cap, 2 unpaired electron. That is one contribution, -1.2 dQ. Then D9 is there. That means T2G6. Eg3, unpaired electron 1, half, -0.6 dQ, 1.2 plus 0.6 dQ is equal to 0.6 dQ over here. That is G10 is there, T2G6, Eg3.